Hey, and welcome to Sekiro The Ultimate Guide. Now, if this is your first time watching any of these videos, then I'd ask for a minute or so of your time just so I can explain how to use this guide and what it's about. Essentially, this guide is entirely complete and it will help you get a full platinum for Sekiro. It covers all NPC quests that are relevant, all items, a best path through the game, and also specifically strategies to get you through the game with the path of least resistance. Remember that this guide is supposed to be used as a full guide, but you can use it for specific areas if you need to. But if you're confused about how, you know, we are at a certain point or doing a certain thing, chances are the answer is in a previous episode. When it comes to boss battles, we really only show you the easiest method that we could find based on our perspective. If you want to fight the boss differently, it's up to you in this case to find a different and harder strategy. Now, if you have a good tip or have a question, leave them in the comments and I'll add them to a pinned post. That way this guide can constantly get better or more efficient. So if you have a question, check the pinned post first. If you do have a tip, please leave a timestamp so I can find the bit that you're talking about. Also, please bear in mind that this guide is taking me literally hundreds of hours to make. So if you enjoyed the video, the least you could do is give it a like. If you really enjoyed it, perhaps give us a sub. And if you really, really enjoyed it, you can support the channel on our Patreon if you're feeling generous, or perhaps sub to us on our Twitch. That's another good option. Now on to the guide. Alright guys, and welcome back to part 5, but also technically part 6 of the Sekiro Ultimate Guide.
Stop saying the parts, you're just going to confuse people.
Yeah, okay, welcome back to the next part. So, okay, today it is Ashina Castle, and this is like the main center area of the game that kind of leads on to other areas. So I'm just, we're just bashing through this like super quickly. So what I'm doing is essentially just opening up all the other routes before we like move on through like the rest of the area, I suppose. So this is like, later in the game, you have to enter through this area, and that's why opening this door is like relevant, I guess.
So first things first is abandoned dungeon.
No, this is the reservoir first,
isn't it?
Nah. Well, you can get to the dungeon this way, but
the dungeon's then opposite. Yeah. From where we start. Okay.
So we're just getting this idol or bonfire. They will be referred to as bonfires from now on.
This is the location of a very sucky boss in future.
It's not sucky if you know how to do it right. Yeah. So look forward to that, because I'm not going to give it away.
But this is the tutorial area.
Yeah, so now you're like back at the start essentially. But all we're doing is just like opening up the paths. These specific areas have their own part later in the game. So this is the entrance to the dungeon this way.
If you're standing on the bridge, look to your left. Like, if you're standing on the bridge at the start of Ashina, look to your left and you can jump straight over here.
Yeah, yeah.
As well. Just so you can map it out in your mind.
So you can like eavesdrop these guys, but you actually need to kill these guys, oddly enough, because they drop a key that gives you a... they drop that, which gives you an item later on, or rather a shinobi tool specifically. But yeah, all we're doing is just kind of coming up here. So there's like this guy, and you can kind of like juke him, I suppose. It's not like the biggest deal if he sees you or not, but you can like hit the dogs and go that way, and then you can like run to his side when his like back's turned, or you can just do that. Inexplicably, he doesn't see you if you do it fast enough. I don't fucking get it either. Doesn't really make any amount of sense. Oh, okay, so in this one he did see me. I'll do a quick cut in a second to show you doing it properly.
You just hide behind the door.
Yeah. But really, you just don't want to fight these guys, like, legit. So...
Women, aren't they?
Nah, I think it is guys.
I'm convinced that these warriors were women or something.
Well, whatever the fuck they aren't whatever they were, so...
definitely not.
So we're picking up some coins, and this is the start of the dungeon, but again, we're not doing this just now.
You can buy... We already have firecrackers here, but is this the merchant that you can buy it from?
No, it's another one.
Is it?
So this guy sells one of the mask fragments, one of the pieces of it. So we need to get that later on in the game. If you have... So we are selling some coins. Ah, right, so sell 1,000 of your coins in order to get... 1,400, rather, in order to get that prayer bead. So we're picking up one early. Also, we're doing the guide like for this part a little bit differently. There's a boss like right at the start, but we're not going to do him. We're actually waiting until a bit later, because you don't need to do him as soon as you see him. And when you do him later on, you're like... There's like bosses that you have to do before you get to them. But anyway, that's kind of neither here nor there. We are going to stealth up to the roof now, which gets us to the next part of Ashina Castle. Obviously, in front of the... So just do exactly what we are doing. You want to go up, grab onto the ledge, and then you follow these ledges, and it lets you not get seen by any of the enemies. Repel onto the roof, lets you backstab this nightjar. By the way, this took me so fucking long to work out, so please like the video. Anyway though, you can now drop attack this guy. Now, sometimes this will alert one of the guards down there. That happened a couple of times in some of my tests. Sometimes it doesn't, so it doesn't really matter. This is one of those cases where stealth is irrelevant. All that matters is like you kind of do up to this point stealthily, and then that kind of makes the rest of it sort of easier.
How did that guy not? Oh, I did see you.
Okay, yeah, yeah, he did. He was just outraged.
I thought that was his indicator that was yellow there, and I'm like, what? You just watched them get murdered.
So now, so the thing is with all that ruckus, there's like a little patrol. So that's the one thing that you want to just time. Make sure that the patrol with the dog, which is on that in that lane over there where the dog's going to, just make sure that they're like far enough away that they won't get like kind of noticed. But again, it doesn't like super matter. Nothing really matters, and like if you fuck up in the game. Also, I mean, nothing really matters like conceptually, but that's not for this kind of video.
Yeah, but you can't quit and reload. But in the game, you can.
Yeah.
So if you get overwhelmed, just quit and reload, and the enemy position gets reset.
So they reset their aggro or whatever. So now they're back on their bullshit or
the predetermined route.
Yeah. So basically, you know, you can see how they go quite far out. If you just time to make sure they're like far out when you're doing the drop attacks on those enemies, and you can tell where they are if you're on the roof or whatever. But so you shuriken the dog, and then you make sure you kill the guy with the reeds because he's like slightly harder, and then you mark this guy, and
Or you get marked by this guy.
Yeah, this guy gave like Jesus. He went ham. Like he was just like, for Ashina. And then I'm like, fuck that. Look, he still goes out, he still gets that last fucking hit.
Give that man a raise. Two bowls of rice.
So there's a couple of items to pick up here just before we move on. There's some black gunpowder, I think that's what that was.
Scrap iron.
And Fistful of Ash, this lets us... I mean, both are useful items, so it's good to get them. So now we're moving on. Moving on up. And... So you want to come onto the roof bit. I think if you go up from not the roof, you get caught. So you want to come on. You want to do exactly the route that I had. If you take the little rappel line up, I'm pretty sure it aggroes that nightjar. So just remember that. If you're crouching here, none of the other enemies around will see you. So that's like also kind of important. Because these guys are just a pain in the arse, honestly. They just move about too much. So backstab that guy and then it allows you to... Now this lets you like take care of these guys. So there is a way of timing this, and I do kind of fuck it up here. It just doesn't really matter. But this patrolling guy here, when he is at his absolute apex of his patrol in that little lane that he kind of walks into, if you time it well enough, you can just like straight up like backstab him without alerting him. But again, doesn't really matter.
It's two-shot and everything.
Like, in order to do it properly, it's more hassle than it's worth to learn. So it's one of those moments.
You deflected that thrust attack instead of Mikiri countering, by the way. You got deflect on it, just want to let you know.
So remember that the axe will just, like, straight up allow you to just go, like, axe, kill. So that's pretty good. So there's a guy coming up here. You want to talk to this peddler dude because this is the guy that I said in an earlier part where he goes to the temple. He will then be a merchant for you. So you want to get. So you talk to him, exhaust his dialogue, and then at some point in the game, I don't actually know what the specific trigger is. He will. It's just as you move through Ashina castles. At some point, he goes to the temple. And that's
probably
good.
After this.
So you want to take this route. This is so important, right? Take a Gachin Sugar, like when you're on the ground, or at least on this. And you can, if you angle the camera well enough, get a rappel point up to this corner point here. Then, but you want to be Gachin Sugar for this part because all the night jars will see you, and it is like so fucking annoying if you're not Gachined right now. But then you come up, you backstab this guy. And then and now, we're just going to do a classic Gay for Games move. Run!
Yeah. oh, dodge this guy who's flying in out of fucking nowhere. That absolute mad lad.
So, you know, I'm a big advocate of, like, you know, do things by the book, get all items and stuff, but some parts of the game just straight up aren't worth doing properly, quote unquote. So just run. It's not worth it. This part is simply not worth not running through. Takes you 30 seconds.
And as soon as you're through that window, they all give up.
Yeah.
That's it. Chase over. Like, none of them know how to get in the window. They can backflip and fucking fly out of the sky, but they can't climb through the window.
Window? What is window? So, there we go. Now we're in the antechamber. This is, like, a pretty, crucial, bonfire, I guess. But we now have,
3 skill points as well, and a gourd seed, and a prayer bead.
Yeah. Now, you might have saw that I hadn't used a memory, which is Gyobu's memory. There's like 2 versions of the footage here, and I accidentally didn't use Gyobu's memory to upgrade my attack. In this specific footage that I'm using, the other footage I have, but just remember to make sure that you've upgraded Gyobu's footage. Make sure you've upgraded your attack. So we're going to use a little few coins, upgrade a few more things here, which was the shuriken this time. This just puts us on the path for later. And again, you might just have like passive money, so you don't need to burn through any coin purses. That's the ideal scenario. I'm just, you know, this is just the worst case scenario, essentially. And now we are going to upgrade Fang and Blade. So this is a skill that utilizes the axe, and this is extremely important for beating most enemies coming up through the rest of the game.
Every boss for the rest of the game.
I'm not even really joking, to be honest. But my god, if you're having a problem with the game, suddenly now you're not having a problem with the game, put it that way. So now we can just move through the rest of Ashina, and we are going to crouch kill this guy, easy peasy. And we can open up this door here. Essentially, we're just clearing out the enemies at this part. It's really no big deal. But there is like a certain pattern that you can take that makes things mildly easier, I guess. So he doesn't see you for some reason. Now, what you want to do is you can use a shuriken here to kill this old woman.
Before she screams and starts like...
going off her head.
Yeah. Because if you get overwhelmed by these the guys in the blue robes, they do a decent amount of damage.
Yeah, so this is the thing. These blue guys are still, like, they still give me
They
hassle.
Use Ichimonji. Like, a channeled Ichimonji, and it does a lot of damage.
So, right, here's a thing. You can avoid getting detected by these 2 guys in the next room if you take a Gachin Sugar here. One run that I've done, inexplicably, they never noticed me. I've came back here using the stealth upgrade and they still noticed me. So in order to not get like ganged up on by 2 of these guys, you can raw dog it if you want. But if you take the Gachin Sugar, that's the only way you're going to be able to stealth through that particular part. Now, as you can see, they still give me a problem. So
you died to the thrust because you were too busy using Fang and Blade.
But you know, I want to try out my new toy. You know what I mean? But as you can see, you can just like power through a lot of their attacks using the axe. So.
Just ignore the main mechanic of the game, deflect. You don't need it. Just Fang and Blade, and then when you die, revive.
So there's certain enemies where you do need to deflect. So I do recommend learning it. But for the mean part, you know, if you can't be arsed thinking that day, then by all means.
Another prayer bead.
So there's another prayer bead. There's a heavy coin purse behind that little screen there. So remember to pick that up.
They head to the big one behind the screen.
Yeah, you know the crazy thing is like the rooms with like the prayer beads and stuff, there's like 2 of them that are literally just straight up hidden in the game.
Yeah.
And it's just bullshit because if you miss them, then it's like, if you're going in blind, how the fuck are you ever meant to know about them? Anyway though, so we're up in the rafters here, and this is one of these parts, right? So the main thing is use the shuriken to kill the old woman, right? And then, essentially, you just have to, like, drop down, backstab this guy, and then you have to 1v1 this guy. You can use, like, ceramic shards and shit to, like, bait this guy forward, and you can get him into, a drop attack situation. But again, it's one of those scenarios where the effort put into it just isn't worth trying to achieve on a consistent basis. I could show you me doing it, but then you could waste all your ceramic shards just never getting it done. So, it's not worth showing it as, like, a technique that you can do. Now remember, open this door right now, because if you don't, later in the game it's going to fuck you over. So now there's a bonfire up here.
Idol.
No, bonfire.
No. Idol.
This is just like, say it right, it's chowder. Chowder. No Simpsons reference for you there. But anyway, so get the bonfire. And there's a boss through there, but we're not going to do him quite yet. We're just going to clear out the rest of the enemies in this part before we do the boss. This boss is like super, it's like basically a gimmick boss. It's just like you either beat him or you don't. So we're just going to like wipe up everything, use all our skill points and shit like that. Make sure any gold you've got spare, you go and buy some gold packets. And then we can do the boss. And like if you lose, doesn't matter. You're right outside them and you can just go straight back to doing it. And you're not going to... You know, you're not going to, like, waste any resources. So that's, like, good practice. So this part, it's, like, sometimes you can get it correct, sometimes you can't. This is, like, a super unbelievable pain in the ass. Essentially, what you want to do is just kind of run and break their aggro. But sometimes that doesn't work. So you can use the flame vent, and that'll do, like, an amount of damage. But even then... If you can figure out a foolproof technique for this, then this is one of those things. Leave this in the comments. But I spent literally like an hour and a half trying to work out how to do this. And the best I could get is just like use the flame vent and hit them a couple of times. And I know that's not particularly great, but they move about so much. They're so erratic and they can't be like, you know, their movements can't be like traced like reliably every single time. So it's just a pain in the ass. The best thing is just like use the flame vent, try and get some free hits in. Hopefully you can manage to backstab one of them if you can run away quick enough.
Right, you want to backstab that one the most. He's the most dangerous out of all of them, I think.
I think they're just to do the same. I mean, maybe not. Now pick up the eel liver and the pellet. I mean, obviously you're not just going to run past them, are you? And then you pick up Ishin's letter, which is still like a little bit of lore for you, I guess. Now there's a couple of like semi-hidden items like on the roof. There's only like two of them. The guide says there's three, but I spent about 45 minutes trying to find the third one. It just doesn't exist.
It's down on the ground floor.
Fuck knows, man. Could not find it. It's supposedly a coin purse, but it wouldn't matter to the overall run anyway. So if you can find it, cool. But I checked a lot and I just couldn't find it. So coin purse under there. And that is pretty much it for all those items. So we can just use the homeward idol to just go straight back to, you know,
the
dojo bonfire.
Yeah, the dojo.
Which is where we want to be, because that's outside the boss. So
that we're not fighting.
No, we do the boss. It's either now or we do a little bit first before the boss. One or another.
Alright, guys, it's the boss.
We've done everything now. So if it was you, make sure you just look ahead. If you've got any spare skill points, burn them. If you've got any spare gold, make sure to spend on gold packets. But otherwise, what you want to do is you'll see a little flash on his hilt, then you just block twice. As soon as you see the flash, just block twice, and you just do that three or four times, and you get the kill move on him. And don't even bother attempting to do him any other way. If he hits you, he does like an extraordinary amount of damage. It's kind of fucked, to be honest. So just do it this way. And if my shitty reaction times can do it, then you can definitely do it. And there you go, that's the boss done.
Yep. For those of you who are feeling up to it as well, then there's like that unblockable attack that he used there was a slashing attack. You can jump over that and jump on his head to inflict more posture damage between your blocks. If you're using Ichimonji, you can jump on his head and then chain that into an Ichimonji on your descent.
As long as you have the skill that lets you do the skills in the air. But so that's it. We picked up a few items around there. Picked up another eel liver, which raises your lightning defense. That's relevant for another boss. Because technically now we can do Genichiro, which is like essentially Ornstein and Smough of, oh my god. Essentially Ornstein and Smough of Sekiro. But we're not doing them just yet. We can do a whole lot of the game first. So again, we could just keep going forward and try to do them, and you won't. But you can now go out the back of Ashina Castle. So this is the guy here is like the hardest guy, so you just like drop attack him and then you just have three menial enemies
you
to take care of.
You can fang and blade your way through all of these no problem at all.
It's true, you literally can, so just kind of use that to your advantage, just a shortcut. You also don't want to be wasting emblems.
Oh, he's using his ghillie suit.
Yeah, yes. What's the Call of Duty thing? Is that all ghillied up or something?
Yeah, all ghillied up. Because that's the mission with McMillan or something his name was.
So there's the eel liver.
Is this Sabimaru? No.
It is Sabimaru. Is it? Yeah. Yeah, well remembered.
Oh, okay. What's the one in the... Is it the spear that's in the tutorial area?
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's the thing that you need the key for.
Yeah.
So okay, now we can open up this as well. And this is, you'll see there's the boss that I was talking about. But ultimately, still not going to do that just yet. That's for a later part. I mean, you could do them if you want. It'd probably be easy enough, but... I'm just, you know, if you're following the guide to the letter, you're going to get the easiest time doing it a wee bit later.
Yeah, we don't fight bosses, we run away.
So, like, as an example, there's still prayer beads and gourd seeds, I think, to get before you need to fight him. So you might as well be as strong as possible. Like, you know, this isn't like a typical RPG where you can just, like, straight up pump your experience into leveling stats. Like, essentially, there's, like, hard cutoff points about, like, how strong you can be at a certain point before doing X. And considering he's totally optional, you might as well just, like, go and get all the other shit.
I don't think you wouldn't need to fight him at all.
Oh, I mean, you could actually just miss him. Like, the whole game, you could just
miss him. Does he drop prayer bead or anything?
He probably does drop a prayer bead or something.
Yeah, then that's, like, the only reason you'd want to fight him. Otherwise, yeah, skip him, because later on in the game, he's going to be dead anyway by the time Stage 2 Ashina comes. So...
Yeah, I don't know what happens if you do just skip him. Like, so we'll see what happens when he drops at the time, because I can't quite remember off the top of my head. But, like, if you don't kill him before a certain point in the game, maybe you literally just can't get his item, which would be kind of interesting.
Probably. It's probably a prayer bead.
So, this is the old grave. There's a dragon blood droplet there. That's, like, the dragon rot item. Yeah. So all it does is stops enemies coughing, which is an annoying noise. So,
well, to be fair, if they're not wearing a mask, then they need to be like 2 meters away.
I'm sure that won't make sense in 3 years. Anyway, so what you want to do is you want to go around that kind of tower and then you backstab that guy, because otherwise it just alerts anybody else. Those are the cannon guys that are super annoying, so make sure you kind of just done exactly what we've done there. Now, this might alert a guy, it might not alert a guy, depending where he is on his patrol, like this guy here. So you can just wait until he's like up the stairs, accidentally hit, like, done an attack which alerted him, but it doesn't really matter.
He has a spear and you have Makiri counter. It's not a bit, or you can just hit R1.
Yeah, I mean, that's how most enemies die, is just
hit R1. A dex build, hit R1. Like, everyone's using a dex build, that's why they have no health.
Yeah, this is true. So now we can come down here and there's a merchant guy in there. I mean, I'll show you in a little second. So this is like one of those pan hitter guys. Just use a shuriken to kill him. And this guy sells you one item that's irrelevant and another item that's super relevant. So the Iron Fortress is like literally required for certain parts of the game. But we get that far later on. Like, there's a point where it's, like, relevant to buy it and you have the spare cash, but right now, don't. So there's a guy down here, like, under this tree, just, like, staring at the wall for some reason. He needs to be reprimanded.
The horrors of battle. He's Blair Witching.
He's got the pure 1,000 yard stare. So if you come this way as well, it means that you can avoid being detected off the cannon guy, which is, again, super important. Again, I worked this run out for you, so if it helped you, like the video. Because I'm telling you, no other cunt fucking done this. Nobody else done this, I done this.
If you get hit by the cannon though, it's probably your fault.
Yeah, probably. So you can kill this guy, that's like the last guy. I think there might be like one item down there right on the edge of the bridge.
The bridge.
And this is actually, looks over where the snake bit is. This takes you all the way back there, and later on in the game, it does open up as a shortcut, but it's not, like, super functional.
Hey, anyway. More stealth sugar.
Yeah, it's probably the most, like, useful item in the game.
It is, by far.
So that should be it. I think there's one more item to pick up, but that should be it for the old grave. Yeah, there's this thing here, which is another Gachin sugar. Hey! Well remembered on my behalf. So
it's
now,
like fucking like a little granny with about 1,000 Wuthers originals in her bag at this point.
Yeah.
This one will make you hide better.
So, this bit can just be like a pain in the arse trying to like bait these guys out like one at a time. Again, one of those doesn't really matter scenarios. It's just like mildly convenient if you manage to do it or not. But So I thought that, like, I thought that if they're alerted, you'd still be able to get the grab on them, but apparently not. But again, you can just use Fang and Blade, doesn't really matter.
Or Makiri counter.
Yeah, or if you're a good Makiri counter, but I'm, you know, I'm not, so.
You don't even have to be good. You just need to dodge into it.
Yeah, but sometimes you end up dodging, like, a diagonal.
You just can't.
Okay, so there's a bit here that's, like, required, right? You need to eavesdrop on this bridge. Because it is required for the merchant's quest. Because he asks you if you exhausted his dialogue, which I told you to do. He will... Even if you haven't exhausted his dialogue back then, you can still go back and like start his quest like whenever you want. By just exhausting the dialogue. But if you eavesdrop here, they'll give you the information that he requires. Apparently the guards want salt or some shit like that. So
they're gonna salt the fields.
Yeah, I don't know if that was what I don't think I've actually even paid attention. I just saw the word salt and I'm like,
oh yeah, okay. Make sure that when you get the lethal that you're doing it on the one that Tony hit.
Yeah.
Because he's the stronger of the two.
Absolutely.
He's actually, I think he's the same as the enemy that you fought, like the
in the
boss
tutorial area,
of the
yeah.
tutorial area.
So he will be like a slightly harder guy. So just,
I mean, he's easy now, but he is slightly tougher.
Yeah, if you want a slightly marginally less of your time taken up by having to kill him, then backstab him first.
Spinning Shuriken the Monkey.
Yeah,
so with that Shuriken upgrade.
So literally that is why I got the Shuriken upgrade, just because it makes this bit the slightest bit easier. I mean, you have to upgrade it to get the later stuff anyway.
Yeah.
And it just makes this bit like 2% easier.
You know, coming here later with the Beast Whistle is fantastic.
So you have to do that, and yeah.
Start a riot.
So here's the other bonfire. This is the last part for this video. That should be all the items.
And that's all the pathways opened up for later as well.
Yeah, and the next part is we go... So the next part is like a little kind of interim part. It's just doing a few things that we want to get done now before moving on. And we will leave this part there and see you in the next one. Catch you later, guys.